And welcome back to MD Globe Muscle here at the On The Rise Media Studio with me, your host, Giles Thomas. I know we had him on again last week, but we've got him on again because he's won his pro show. He's going to the Olympia Theatre again. Yeah.
Hello.
Hello again.
Hello again.
Yeah. We've done this fresh. We didn't do this last week, did we? Because you've got the same jacket on.
No, this is another one, but this is the same color, yeah.
Ah, okay. Mate, congratulations. You won the show.
Yeah, thank you very much. I told you, this is, you know, this is time, you know.
6th, 4th, 2nd, 1st.
Yeah. No, 1 week before, I feel very good, you know, for the victory. You know, sometimes you know what you make, you know, like a premonition. And all is good. Now I go back to my house with the Olympic qualification, you know.
Yeah, second one.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it was the same guys, but do you think that was your best look? Because I really liked, you're very consistent. You always look good. But do you think this was your best look so far this year?
Yeah, I think, yeah. I think, and Mauro, he told me that, and so much people, he told me that too. I think I have the same mass of Lille, but I'm a little bit drier and harder.
Mm. Do you find it tough doing so many shows? I know you're very experienced with it, but do you find it tough doing show after show after show, or do you find you get better, or do you find that?
I'm better show after show, and I just make a little bit sitting, you know, the day night before the show, because my muscle don't have not good reaction, but 100% explosive reaction the night before the show. I just switch the carbs for my last meal, you know, and Monday morning and the morning of the show, it's you know, perfect. I just drink a little bit less the day of the shows. I'm Lille, and I'm a little bit drier. And yes, I come with another best package show after show, you know. And show after show, this is my best package.
Also, you made Lauren cry with your posing routine.
Ah.
She cried. She cried.
It was beautiful.
Yeah, I didn't cry.
Yeah, thank you very much. I want to try, you know, another style. I call her because my grandbrother, he make my music all the time, you know. And I call him Friday, just before the meeting broke. Yeah, and because I saw a reel in Instagram with this music, I say, probably it's a good idea if I make a posing in this music, you know. Mm. I called my brother, hey, and I told him, yeah, bro, it's possible to make me another music.
Yeah.
Say, I'm on the weekend, I just want to go drink a beer, you know.
Nice.
But okay, no problem. He make that. I give the music in registration Friday. I don't know what I make, but in Sunday he works very good. You know, this is more slowly, more melancholic. You know, but I like that too. And Mauro, he like that. The wife of Mauro, he have too much emotion too.
And nice.
Yeah. And no, I feel a great sensation on the stage, you know, and I want to make another great show and entertainment for the public, you know, for the audience, you know. Yeah. Again, yeah, different style, but all the time I want to make to create an emotion, you know, motivation, funny, melancholic, but I want to, you know, to give an emotion.
Yeah, no, it was brilliant. It was really good because, you know, I love good conditioning and I love good posing.
Yeah.
That's, and it was just, I was like, because like I said, I've said this many times to you before, I've never seen you off. You're very, very polished. In fact, I think as the shows go on, you get more polished, more professional. Like every little detail, you're very, very sort of, there's a lot of attention to detail, which sometimes other guys, you know, very consistent. Everything's always, like I said, top notch.
Yeah, yeah. Show after show, I improve my professionalism, you know?
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah. I show all the detail, my skin, the tan, what I put on my skin, oil or Vaseline. Now I put Vaseline, just a little bit of Vaseline, because I don't sweat, and it's better on the light. And yes, and I improve my my analogy of the on the stage to, you know, my presence, my and my attitude, you know, when I make the battle with the guys, because I think in the past time, probably I just feel a little bit boring comparison after comparison. Now I'm more consistent, like a battle, and I try to improve. That's, you know, show after show too. Yeah. It's very important for one time probably go to the top.
Yeah, I mean, like there was two shows out of these four where Tim Budesheim got his tan wrong, and I think it really, it's like, why would, how can you get that wrong? Do you know what I mean? You're super consistent every single show. Your tan is absolutely perfect. So anyway, so obviously with this show, did you feel 100% confident going in? That you were going to win? You were going to win?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's, honestly, yes. This is not... I don't know the word. Arrogant to tell that, you know.
No, it's not.
Yeah, this is just... I'm just confident, you know. I feel that because I know it's possible, because the last week in, you know, in Lille, I'm second, and I know what's possible to make. And... The week before, I'm in Italia, and Andrea Presti show me, you know, he take a video and show me, he tell me on Thursday, for me, this weekend you win 100% with
nice.
This condition, feel like that, you know, I say, oh, okay, and in the backstage of the show, day of the show, Andrea is here too with Mauro, another guy, he just want to see a couple pose, you know, in a warm up for take video, and I saw, you know, all the guys front of me like that. So, I say, okay, it's for tonight. It's for tonight. When I make the double back,
yeah,
all the guys say, ah, fuck,
you nice. Know,
hey,
so. What was Mauro's feedback after the prejudging? Because personally, on the live stream, I had it very close between you and Tim. I thought that was the one and two. I thought, okay, this is either going to go to Tim or Theo. I can't decide. I kept deciding back and forth.
Honestly, I think the same of you. I don't put on my mind. I don't saw the show, you know, but on my mind, yes, I probably put Tim in second in the prejudging, you know. I think it's the battle is with Tim. Mm. And because I saw Tim in the backstage, he's fuller.
Yeah.
Fuller than ever. And he spilled it too. But probably, you know, this is a line too, because the way my waist is really... much tight of Tim, you know, and now my stomach is very lean. I don't eat protein the day before, okay. And my stomach is really, really empty. I make the vacuum on the scene, mm-hmm. And I play with that, you know. And for all the pose in the profile, I have much deeper abs than usually, and I think this is different. But yes, when I saw Tim, I said, wow. He's in the shape. He's in the shape. Tim is a very great athlete, and he competed since a very, very long time, you know. And I hope one time he's qualified to Olympia. Yeah. I wish for us, you know.
Yeah. Well, I spoke to this morning, I spoke to Patrick Tour.
Yeah.
Excuse me. And he had you the clear winner. He had you the clear winner.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah.
He tell me on the backstage, you know, after prejudging.
Yeah.
Okay, Theo, see you in Orlando.
Yeah. No, he said you had the better flow, the better physique, the better symmetry. He said he actually had his guy Alfred in second, and I think probably Tim third. But it just shows you how close it was, you know, between those top five guys. Because the thing is, you didn't just win; you actually beat, like I said, you beat Tim and Roman, who beat you in the other Italy show.
Yes, it's very close, and the level is very consistent, you know. But Patrick, he's seen the real, you know. And honestly, the photo and streaming is difficult, you know, to have a very good idea, especially for me, because all the time, video and picture, you don't make a good justice of me, you know. Mm-hmm. And in the real, you have a 4D, you have mass separation, you know. Okay, Roman, he have a very V shape, you know, but he don't have the same 3D effect, you know.
Yeah.
And Tim in real, in the photo, is wow, like a tank, you know. In real, behind me, this is not the same too. But in the real, yeah, Patrick, he told me you have the good balance, you know, the mass package. You are plastic, conditioning, mm-hmm. mass, line. Pose by pose, you win.
I feel like, I think it really, with guys like Andrew Jacked, and Samson, I feel like they're going for more pleasing, symmetrical, balanced physiques this year. I feel like with the guys, you know, they're not the biggest, the freakiest, the most shredded guys are winning some of the big shows at the moment. And I think that really stands in your favor.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. I think this is a way he's debuted that since 1 year and a half, you know. And now this is a result of that. So I think the league, you want to push this type of physique, you know, not extra mass like a monster, but he want to have a big classic bodybuilder, you know. Mm-hmm. And yes, like Andrew, Samson, probably Derek too. This is not like same physique, but he have, you know, he's healthy, he have a good face,
yeah,
he have small waist, he have a abs, deep abs. No, I think it's very good. It's very good direction for me, because it's possible to take the train, you know.
Yeah. So there's 19 guys in the Open this year.
Yeah.
It's down to 19 because obviously Valliere and Rami aren't doing it. So that's basically, we worked it out today on the Power Hour. So
if Kamali competing Open, no,
he's been in Libya.
We are 18, not 19, I think.
Who, sorry? Oh, 19. Oh, it was 18. No, I think I'm sure we counted 19 today.
Nathan, he come 19.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he says he's doing Romania, Nathan. But we'll see if he gets to the Olympia. I'm fingers crossed. I want to see him at the Olympia, you know. So what's what's your goal for this year's Olympia then? What are you really wanting to achieve there?
Honestly, I don't know. I think we are 9 men or 10 with the same level. This is a big battle for the one place at the final.
Yeah.
It's possible to be, but we will see, you know.
Well, I mean, I was saying to Lauren actually before, I said, like, for the Olympia last year, I said, even though there was, you know, like Hadi, Derek, Samson, a lot of the guys, even Brandon, a lot of the guys, yeah, they did well, but they didn't bring their best conditioning. I said, someone like Theo can, you know, with, because you know he's going to be on, you know, like I said, you know, I know you're going to be in condition. You're going to symmetry, conditioning, presentation, you know, you tick all those boxes. And I think that's why I think people might be underrating you for a really, really good placing.
Yeah. No, I think this year is really good option, because we are not the same competitor of last year, you know, and last year I don't have the opportunity to show my physique with other guy, you know. He don't call me in a good lineup, in a good call out, you know. And this is difficult to show your physique behind, you know, the top 10 guys. Of you don't have this opportunity, but okay, last year I think I'm a little bit, you know, he don't saw me too much, you know. He don't want to have a good comparison for me and like that, you know, because when I saw the call outs behind me, I know my level, you know, and I say I am level for me the battle with this guy, but I hope this year the opportunity to have a good comparison, and probably if you we will be not extra competitor and for just the first round with the other guys, it's possible to show my level, you know.
Yeah. So are you excited for this year's Olympia? Being in Florida as well?
What?
Are you excited for this year's Olympia, being your second Olympia?
Yeah. And, you know, this is a big dance, you know. I want to have another close, you know, with my name.
Yeah. It's cool.
You know?
Yeah.
And no, all the time is very good, you know. It's a big show. I'm honored, you know, to participate to Mr. Olympia. When you are in the same room of the whole the guys, you know, in the pro registration, in the meeting pro, you say, ah, fuck, I'm here.
Yeah. Theo, one thing I'll ask, how old are you now? Because I've got you around 30, 31?
31, yeah.
31. So you've already made, you've already got a good career. And you're still so young, mate.
I hope. Because, you know, I think in the bodybuilding, the prime is at 35, you know.
Up.
Yeah.
Up.
Probably
up. Yeah.
But you start at your big level at 35, probably, you know.
Yeah.
And yes, I have time for that, for improve again.
Mm-hmm.
More hardness, more woodless, you know, especially on the front. And if I rocks... if I make an intelligent works, it's possible, yeah, to be at the final as a Mr. Olympia.
Yeah. Well, you've qualified, mate, and you just made it in the show, so I'm really happy. And I actually feel bad for guys like Tim and some of the other guys, because the point system is gone. Tim probably would have got through, you know, on points. You know, I feel bad for him, do you know what I mean? But at the end of the day, the Olympia is the best of the best, isn't it?
Honestly, I tell you before, I wish Tim is qualified one time, because when after the show he come to me for just say, hey, congratulations, bro, I'm happy for you.
Yeah.
And you know, I show he's not disappointed. He's just sad.
Yeah.
You know. And I feel that. And for me, he touched me on my heart, you know, because I know what we make for to be at this level, you know. And I feel that not disappointed, not jealous, nothing, just sad, you know.
Yeah. Well, I feel like there's a lot of support and love between the European guys, you know. Like, you know, you're obviously Andrea Presti's, you know, guys like that, you know, he's obviously with Maro as well, you know, so there's you know, that a lot of the European guys seem to really support each other, because obviously I think because you compete against each other so often, maybe you spend a lot of time with each other, but a lot of you have the same sponsors.
Yeah, for sure. And I don't know if it's the same for all the guys, but with me, you know, this is like a high one brother, you know. All the guys make the same, all the guys we have pain all the day, you have a lot of sacrifice. And when you saw all this pain, you know, it's possible you to win week after is him. But it's for me, it's really important, you know, to don't have a ego battle of nothing like that. And with these guys, Roman, Tim, and Vlad, this is a really good friendship, you know, in the backstage, on the stage too. You want to enjoy, because you make hard work all the day, and now it's just time to enjoy. And the result is the result.
Yeah.
But we are here. We are the brother of Iron, you know, and enjoy and respect all.
Final question. I know it's the Olympia's coming up, and that's huge. But any thoughts to Prague or Romania? Come on.
Honestly, I don't talk about that.
Oh, okay. Okay.
No, honestly, I don't talk, because you know, I just come back home, and. Yeah, you know, in Olympia, if you are in a good condition, you say, this is just one week after.
Why not?
I don't want to have a regret.
Yeah.
If you don't compare and you saw the lineup and you say, probably it's possible to win.
Yeah.
Fuck, I don't want to be in my sofa when I saw that.
Yeah, watching the live stream thinking, shit, I could have won 20 grand there. Bloody hell, I got a third pro win.
ready. This is just 5 days more, you know?
Yeah.
But probably yes. Okay.
Well, I'm going to be in Prague.
Okay.
I'm doing live stream, and guess who I might be doing it with? Nathan. Possibly. He might be coming with me. Do the commentary.
Yeah, okay.
So that'd be cool. So I thought, it'd be cool anyway. Lauren, anything you want to ask? He's drinking some tea. Anyone want to ask Theo before I let him go?
Good luck, Theo.
And cross the finger for me for make a final, because if I make the final,
yeah,
opposing routine at the Olympia.
Oh man, top ten, yeah.
I wish you all the best, Theo.
Yeah, I would love to see you make top 10, mate. I think that'd be a really, because you know what? I asked Ronnie Coleman. You know,
my dream, this is not just I tell you, am I in the top 10? I just want, you know, to have
pose.
To have the laundry, you know, like that.
Yeah, the smoke. The ice, yeah, the dry ice.
With the smoke and the light, you know, yeah. Just like a kid. I'm just like a kid for that.
Well, I was going to say this earlier. I asked Ronnie Coleman what his most special, memorable Olympia he ever did was. And I was expecting 98, 2003. And he said 1992, the first Olympia he ever did. He didn't even get a call out. He said because that was his first Olympia. That was his starting point.
Oh.
Isn't that... Yeah. That blew my mind.
Mm. Yeah.
Crazy. Right. I'm going to let you go, mate. But thank you so much for giving us this winner interview, mate. And I'm so happy. Your dad rang me straight away. As soon as the live stream finished, I was over there doing some editing. And your dad rang me on WhatsApp, and he went, "Yeah, he would." So, how was the meal last night? Was it nice with all your family?
Yeah. No, last night I ate a fish.
Yeah.
fish like real fish, you know, big fish, and faux filet and duck, you know.
Oh, nice.
I don't eat any cheat, you know.
No cheat at all.
No. I like, you know, the good food. I just eat a good fish, great fish, you know, with faux filet and duck and like a good restaurant, you know. I like a gastronomy, you know. I don't want to have, I don't know, kebab or pizza. No, it's just time, you know, to have a good food, you know.
See, that's why you keep coming in condition, because you don't pig out.
Yeah, for sure.
Theo, mate, it's like I said, congratulations, mate, and all the best for this next 4 weeks. You know, work hard, mate, and I really want to see you in that top 10, mate. I think it's a possibility. Very strong.
Yeah, thank you. I work for that, and I give all for. Thank you very much for your invitation, and all of time. This is a very, very cool moment and happiness for me.
All right, then, mate. Well, I'll speak to you very soon, and hope to see you maybe in Prague.
Yeah, maybe.
Cool. All right, Theo. Thank you for coming, MD Glove Muscle, and I'll speak to you very soon, mate.
Yeah.
All right. Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Okay, guys, we're going to do an Olympus Pro Italy Milan kind of live stream review. We're doing this live with myself and Lauren Lotta. Say hi.
Hi, everyone. Hope you're all okay.
Okay, we're going to go straight into Simone Bassanelli. They're bringing them out one at a time at the moment. So, Simone, it's been a good season. This is the first time I've ever seen him competing. I believe this is his third show of the season. Look at the quads, Lauren.
Oh, I like him.
Yeah. So, okay, that's him gone. Okay, next we've got...
Sorry.
Okay, come on.
It's been a while, you guys.
I know. Who's next? Okay, so I've got one of the favorites for the show. We've got Tim Budesheim from Germany. This is actually, I don't know whether it's just the lighting, but everyone looks better. Theo, Vlad, Tim, which is my top three. Tim Budesheim is just getting better and better every single week. Jeez. He looks really, this is the best I've seen him. This is the best I've ever seen Tim.
Yeah, this is the best Tim.
Yeah, you've got to stick to the mic. He looks good. Yeah, he looks thick. He looks dense, dry. He's conditioning. I think the lighting is very complimentary in this show. It's really highlighting their conditioning. Whereas in some other events like France, maybe the lighting wasn't so good. So the guys didn't kind of weren't able to look their best. Mm. So, he looks very, very good here. Condition looks good. Looks full, hard, grainy, dry. He's obviously, because this is the last chance for the pros in Europe, well, to qualify. looks really good. I think it's yeah, Theo, Alfred, and Tim are my top three. But Tim looks absolutely phenomenal here. But then again, so does Theo. So we've already seen them in their they've been called out numerically, which we watched before this, before we started recording. And this is the all-time best Tim I've ever seen, to be honest. Yeah, he's really, because the best condition I ever saw him was in 2017 at the San Marino. He's a lot bigger this time. And he fixed his tan as well, because his tan in France, again, was terrible. So he's fixed that as well. Okay, so we've got Vlad Alfred Chidiak, who was fifth at the France Pro last week. He was very disappointed with that. I know he really wanted to get the win in the qualification, but obviously had very tough competition from Roman, Tim, Nathan, and who was the other guy? I've completely forgotten. Certainly last week. But Vlad looks very... I'll call him Alfred. Alfred looks very, very good here. I mean, the guy's been in condition for about 2 months now, heavily promoted by his coach, Patrick Tour. But he looks full, dry, hard. For me, I'm still more impressed with Tim. I'm more impressed with Tim and from what I saw from Theo. So I think I'm guessing third. I'm guessing third today. I think Tim and Theo are going to be top two from what we've seen so far. But, you know, we might see. But what do you think, Lauren?
I think he looks great.
He does, doesn't he? Look at that riddle bicep.
Sensational.
He wasn't really moved around much last week in France. He was fifth place. I knew he was very disappointed with that.
I think he looks great.
He does, yeah. Yeah, so he turned pro in 2019. He was a light heavyweight. He was just, how much is it? 188? No, hang on. 190-something pounds. And now he's like, well, probably the 230s. Put on a lot of muscle. He's been working with Patrick Tour since day one. Can you stop yawning, please, Don?
Sorry.
Can it come to the mic?
Sorry, guys.
Yeah, it looks tight. Looks very, very tight. Looks lean. Looks dry. I love the colour as well. The colour looks fantastic. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think he's got... Yeah, I don't think he's going to beat Tim and Theo. That's really disappointing. Hopefully we'll see him at the Romania Pro. Mm-hmm. Or maybe Prague. Maybe try and get an early qualification for next year.
Maybe.
Yeah, so I'll be at Prague as well. Can't wait. So, doing the live stream commentary again.
Unfortunately, I will not be there.
I know.
But...
George is coming with me.
Your bodyguard.
Oh, here we are. Oh, we got Roman Fritz now. Roman's actually qualified for the Olympia. He won the Spain show back in. He beat Emir Omeragic. God, bloody months ago now. Like I said, it's hard to try and recall all the shows because there's been so many now. Two pro shows in Milan as well. I think that's a first in 1 year. But Roman Fritz has been top five in every show since. I mean, like I said, he said he was in condition and he was getting ready for the Olympia, so he's just. Yeah, so we've got Roman Fritz here. Like I said, we just have disconnection issues there. So, obviously he's going to be in condition because he's basically getting ready for the Olympia. He's already qualified and just decided just to keep competing because he was in condition and probably good for his sponsors. And why not? Why not, Aaron? Why not? Just keep competing, you know? Yeah, so... and he's been top five in every single show. And it's, like I said, it's been very close between him, Tim, Theo, and Nathan and all these incredible European pros. Okay, so we've got Theo Legarier here, the Grand Fromage, based on last week's runner-up position to Nathan Diascher in France. I would say that he is the odds-on favourite, but I think he's going to have very tough competition there from Tim and Alfred. But is this going to be enough to win? What do you think, Lauren?
Yes.
Do you think he looks better than Tim?
Oh, he looks fantastic.
He does look fantastic.
I don't want to say he looks better than Tim, but I think he looks different. Like, he's just got a different kind of look.
Yeah.
I like his look.
It's very professional. I mean, if you notice, he's always in... This is the best condition I've seen him in all year. And he's been getting better with every single show. I interviewed him last week. He was obviously on last week's MD Globe Muscle. But, yeah, it looks very, very good. How he just managed to do so many shows. He's so consistent, Theo. Like I said to him in the interview last week, I said, I've never, ever seen him off. Never once seen him off. He always brings good condition, good colour, fantastic presentation. He's a consummate professional. And he looks very, very good here. I am rooting for him because obviously we had him on Global last week and he's a good friend. I mean, I'm rooting for Tim because Tim's awesome as well. I'd love to see Tim get to the Olympia because Theo was at the Olympia last year. Tim has not done Olympia yet.
Oh, I like his bow at the end.
So a little bow, yeah. Cool. So, I've got it between, okay, Tim... Theo and Alfred. That's my top three. And I think the top two is going to be between Tim and Theo. Mm. Okay, so we've got Andrea Mutsi now. Andrea was, I believe he was 12th in Spain, which wasn't a good placing because Andrea is typically always usually in the top five. He's always around the fourth or sixth mark in all the European pro shows. So I was, as an Andrea Mutsi fan, I was very disappointed to see him dropping to 12th in Spain. He brought a different look, and obviously it didn't work for the judges because they placed him accordingly, and they placed him very, very low. I thought 12th was harsh. I thought maybe three or four spots higher. But, I mean, here's a guy that, you know, he's been top three, he's been top five, like Theo in many, many shows. Let's see if he's a bit sharper from the back, because this is where he kind of falls down. He's always a little bit, he's not sharper from the back. Yeah. I think until Andrea Mutsi really sharpens those back shots up, everything from the back top to toe, I feel like this is going to hold him back. And I think he's really been knocked down for it this year. I'm not sure whether they brought him in lighter or to kind of, because he's a guy who competes in like the 260s. So I like his physique, but this has not been a good season for Andrea Mutsi. I don't think he's any sharper either. I'm not seeing, I mean, normally he's got, you know, really good separation in the legs. He's got fantastic legs, but I feel like this has not been Andrea Mutsi's year. So we've got the new Brazilian star. I'll just double check his name. Leandro Perez from Brazil. He was fifth place. He was sixth place in France last week. Not a bad showing for him there. He looks a little bit sharper again this week. But I really like this guy's shape. I think he's got some nice lines. He's got good quality. I think he just needs more size overall. But I think in a couple of years, this guy could be really something quite special. Mm-hmm. What do you think, Lauren? Look at his back shots. The back shots are really good. He's very complete. He's got some nice lines, nice tie-ins. And what do you think, Lauren?
I think he looks really fresh.
Yeah, look at the separation.
I could do with just a little bit more happening on the lower half.
Oh, really?
Just a little bit more. I like his separation and I like the detail, but I just want a little bit more on the lower half, and then everything on the top is looking good.
Do you know what it is for me? It looks like it's a quality physique, and I hope he doesn't lose that kind of separation as he gets bigger. But I've got a feeling this guy's a bit of a work in progress. I think we need to give this guy another year or two to kind of put some more size on. But I think in a year or two, if he does, you know, if he does the right things, I think this guy could really be a top pro in a couple of years, because Brazil has just been pumping out the incredible pros in this last, well, for 4 or 5 years. He's got a kind of quality that Wellington Nascau's got, the kind of very, very crisp separation and the nice, you know, the nice size and separation. Okay, so all the guys have done their individual presentations and we've seen them coming out in groups of five and being compared. So I've had a really good look at these guys to see who's kind of the front runners are. I've got it between Tim and Theo. For me, Tim's actually got a bit of the edge. I've got a feeling Tim might win this.
I think Theo's got the edge.
Yeah, well, it's going to go either way. It's going to go either way. I've got Vlad third, Roman fourth, fifth. I'll have to have another look. I'll have to have a look when we see this first call out. But it'd be interesting to see who they call out first. So I got Tim. Tim will be called out, 302. There you go. And it's been done live, guys. I haven't seen this before. This is literally, yes, Vlad. Okay, Tim, Vlad, Roman, and then Theo. Be interesting to see who they call out, if they call out five guys, because the top four are kind of in a class of their own and the other guys are kind of, you know, in another class. So they're bringing out, so yeah, the four guys. So top five. Oh, so they're bringing out, let me check his name again.
The Brazilian.
Leandro Perez. So yeah, it's pretty much the, it's pretty much similar to, basically it's what I expected.
Oh, they've added another?
Yeah, that's the, I didn't, this
Matthias.
Guy, this guy's name is not on the list. So Matthias, yeah, well, I'd love to know where he's from. But yeah, his condition was very, very, very good, very sharp. So I've got a feeling, why aren't they moving Tim next to Theo?
I'll give him time.
Yeah, I feel like they need to move him around. I don't have Roman in ahead of Tim at all. Yeah. Yeah, come on, Theo. Looks really good. Yeah. Okay, if they don't move Tim into the center, then I think Theo's got it.
The Brazilian man looks great.
And he then does,
this
doesn't
guy
he?
On the left, I really like his physique, and we're curious to know if he switched from classic. So if anyone can comment down below, please do so.
Yeah, because they put the name up, the list, the list of names out for the competitors, and a lot of names have been added, and they're not on the list. So it's quite difficult. And some of these guys, I don't know who they are, so it's quite difficult to. Like Matthias, his name is not on there. I don't know this guy. I've never seen him before. Oh, good. They put Tim next to Theo. So though, basically, Tim, Roman, and Theo are the top three. So it's looking like Vlad might get fourth. I would love to see Vlad get third. Alfred Vlad, what do you want to call him? And then Leandro in fifth. And then was it Matisse? Matisse in sixth place, yeah. So it looks like it's...
See, look at that side shot. Yeah, it's Theo there.
Tim and Theo. Tim and Theo.
That looks great.
That's my top two. I'm sticking to that. I would be happy for either Tim or Theo to get the win and get that last qualification to the Mr. Olympia in, 4 weeks' time now? So let's have a look. See, Tim's drawing my eye more. And he's fixed his tan as well from last week, because it was very close between Tim and Theo for second and third last week. Theo beat Tim, Theo's a little bit sharper from the back, but then Tim's a little bit more denser. He's got a lot more thickness and graininess. Do you know what I mean? Theo's got a prettier shape, but Tim's just got more muscle. I'd have Vlad and Roman switched, because Vlad for me looks better than Roman, but I've got a feeling Roman might actually beat Vlad there, but yeah, I would have Vlad in third. Yeah, that's very good. Yeah, I can't make my mind up between Tim and Theo. In fact, I'm kind of veering more towards Tim. I feel like he's peaked perfectly. He's got more size. And finally, he got his tan absolutely perfect. It was terrible in France. It was good in Spain, bad in France, good in the first Italy show. No, it was bad. I can't remember. But this is the second time he's got his tan right, and twice he didn't. So, and it does make a difference, especially when it's close. I mean, look at Alfred there. Alfred Vlado looks absolutely fantastic. Very polished, conditioned. And his condition is really good. Really good. Yeah, I like Roman's shoulder to waist ratio. Yeah, Theo looks good, but I've got a feeling they'll give it to Tim. I think they're going to give it to Tim.
I think they'll give it to Theo.
Yeah, well, it could happen. I mean, Theo beat Tim last week, but, you know, these things can flip-flop very easily. Yeah.
They all look great.
But they've left Theo in the middle. I mean, maybe even Roman second. I mean, he's been getting some really good placings, and he is already qualified for the Olympia. Personally, I would have... Oh, I can't decide between Tim and Theo. I can't decide. Shut I can't. Okay, I'm going to say it. Tim first, Theo second, Vlad third, Roman fourth, Leandro fifth, and then Matisse on the sixth, on the far left there. I'll have him in sixth.
I'll go different. I'll go Theo, Tim, Roman, Vlad.
Hang on, say again.
Theo, Tim.
Yeah.
Roman.
Yeah.
Vlad.
Yeah.
The Brazilian guy.
Yeah, then Matisse.
And then Matisse.
You're probably going to be right. You're probably going to be right, because based upon what I've seen from the previous shows, I think you're probably going to be right, and I'm going to be wrong on this one.
But it's just my opinion as a future judge.
I know. Yeah, you're very good judge. So, see, I wouldn't have Roman ahead of Alfred at all. I mean, he's just not as big. He's not as big. He's conditioned, but he's got, you know, back and arms. I mean, Alfred's just an absolute tank. But they're not swapping. Look at the density in Tim's back and his traps. Look at that. Look at the lines and the shoulders. Yeah, I've got it. I've given it to Tim. I'm going to give it to Tim. Oh, I don't know, but Theo looks good.
Vlad looks really good Theo on the looks far good. Right on his back shot.
That Who, sorry?
Vlad on the very far right when he hits that back shot. It looks really great.
Yeah, he does. He's got a fantastic back, Vlad. He's just, he's moving up. He's moving up. I'd love to see him get a qualification at, like, say, Romania or something like that, or Prague. But then the thing is, you have to go up against Crizzo in Prague. So I don't think he'd beat Crizzo.
No, I think Crizzo has got it.
Yeah. Although,
right now for a little bit. But you never know. But can I just give some credit to the guy on the far left, Matisse, and his little waist?
Yeah, and you know what? He's very, very well conditioned. He must be very, very happy being first call out. I'll have to do a bit of research on him afterwards. I'll try and find his name and look for his Instagram and see what's what. Because, he looks good. Nice shape. It looks like he's one of those guys that has moved up from Classic.
Well, he's definitely hitting some Classic poses in Open, so...
Yeah, I can't. It literally is a flip of a coin between Tim and Theo. But by the way that they've left Roman there, I'm guessing Roman's in third, Vlad in fourth. But personally, I would have Vlad in third. Alfred, Vlad. What do you want to call him? Tomato, potato. I don't know how to say his name. Well, no, because he uses Alfred and Vlad. So had him on Global a few weeks ago. Check out the interview. Nice guy. Really cool guy. So that was an interesting first call out. Roman looks happy. Like I said, the thing is, he's got nothing to lose because he's already qualified for the Olympia. Okay, so who's going to be the second call out? Thing is, I don't know a lot of these guys because, like I said, the names aren't on the list and there's no numbers to sort of correlate it to. Normally, you know, the full list is out and you can work out who's who. And this is how we learn about the new guys. So there's Andrea Mudsey there, top end of the second call out. That's kind of what I expected. I don't expect him to get 12th this time. I mean, it's not as strong a lineup with not as many big names. This is the other guy with the big, big, huge, wide shoulders. He's a big dude, him. I'd love to know where he's from. Yeah. He looks like something out. He looks like a baddie out of a Jason Statham film. Doesn't he? Doesn't he? He looks like a gangster movie or something, you know? You can imagine him as a mercenary. That's Robert Bonomo. I hope I said that right. I've seen him compete before. And that is... I don't know this guy. Oh, is that Mike Sessler? Mike Sessler. I think that's Mike Sessler. Like I said, it's different. Pain in the ass when the bloody names aren't on the thing. So, have you noticed they don't look as happy when they're in second call out?
No one looks as happy when they're in second call out. I know, but you know,
some of these guys, they're starting their pro careers.
Nobody even likes to be in the last call out. But you know what? It's just a thing. It has to happen.
Sorry, that's not Mike Sessler. I don't know who that is, actually. But like I said, we haven't got the names on the list. So,
you know what my dance teacher used to say to me? She always used to say, the second is the first to lose.
Oh, God.
And I was second for a long time.
That's brutal.
I know.
Yeah, pretty good standard of guys there. Good standard of guys. Like I said, I'm not familiar with several of them, and like I said, it's difficult to not when you can't know the names because they're not on the bloody competitor list. That's annoying. But at least they had a live stream because last week's show didn't have a live stream, did it?
What was last week's show?
France.
Oh.
No live stream.
Come on. Oh.
That's bad, isn't it? It's 2023, guys. Come on, get with the program. Come on, level it up. You know, this is like this should be standard for all IFBB pro shows. You should have a live stream, especially if you've got the big classes, especially like Open, you know, which obviously, you know, the main draw. You should absolutely have a live stream, you know, because a lot of fans are watching from all over the world. They can't attend, you know, and that's just not cool. So Andrea Mudsey, yeah, it's not been a good season for him. I don't know whether I don't know what's going on, but he's definitely slipped this year. Which is a real shame because he's been really going hard since 2020. Mm. Like I said, he's always top six, always you know, fifth or around fifth. He's kind of like a fifth, sixth guy. Looks like he's come down a bit in size, and it's not like it's really gained him any conditioning, and it hasn't made him crisper from the back. So I feel like that's it's not been good for him.
Well, did he get a new coach? Or
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. How am I looking on light, Lauren?
You're looking pretty dark.
I feel like I'm looking a bit dark. Could you get up and lighten me up? Light it up. Right, okay. So the third call out now is going to be the best of the rest. Basically. So, okay. I'm really interested in this final call out because I want to see where the guys are going to be positioned because that will give us an indication of where the judges want to place who. So, I like this guy in the middle. I like the quads, the crazy quads. He lacks a bit from the back.
Who's the crazy quad guy?
This is Simone Bassanelli from Italy. I think it's like third or fourth show of the season now. But I just love this guy's quads. Absolutely incredible. He's got crazy triceps as well. This is probably the best. Well, this is the best condition I've seen him in all these shows. And he just needs a lot more back. But there's another guy a couple of years, if he balances everything out and starts nailing the condition every single time at the shows, I think he'll definitely be moving up in years to come. Look at triceps. Look at that. Almost Ruly side. Ruly Winkler. Mm. Yeah. There's Mark Joyce there, the second from the right guy from the UK. Yeah, I think this is his first year competing. I've got no knowledge on this guy. I don't know where he turned pro. But Bassanelli can't. Look at the triceps. Mm. Wow. His quads are ridiculous. Yes, he's a bit squishy. And there's the back. He needs a lot more going on from the back. He needs to get himself to spin and get some sessions with Dorian Yates there's no back. Give Ronnie Coleman a call and say, what do you do for back, Ronnie? or Sean Clarida. Derek said actually he thinks Sean Clarida's got the best back in bodybuilding right now. He was crazy when he Sean Clarida at the Olympia last year.
Oh my gosh, it was so cool.
I was actually disappointed when I looked at the pictures. Because I was disappointed because it wasn't what I was seeing physically in the flesh was completely blowing me away. So, God, it's getting dark, isn't it? Why is it getting so dark early? It's only 6 o'clock.
Because we're changing seasons.
Like, this has nothing to do with it, Lauren. Right, okay, come on. I want to see the final call out. Oh, they're doing more comparisons now. Oh, ab and thigh. Yeah, Bassanelli, man. God, he ain't skipping leg day, is he?
No, those are massive quads.
Look at them. They're just, they're like, there was a bodybuilder in the 90s, Lauren, called Paul DeMeo, and he's known as Quadzilla. I saw him compete at the 1995 British Grand Prix, and he just had the craziest. He's not with us no longer. The quads were just ridiculous. Jeez. Yeah, ridiculous. And you know when he was training legs, he said once he built the leg size, he never went over 315. So he never went over 3 plates.
Okay.
He said it was just to maintain them because he didn't want them to get them any bigger. So he says, I just do sets and lots of sets with 3 plates. And that was what maintained that level of thickness and density in his legs. Absolutely crazy, isn't it? So, right, okay, then are we going to see a final call out? I do hope so. Because I wonder if they'll do it with 2 or 4 or 5 guys. Or whether that's it. That can't be it, surely. Come on, I want to see one more call out. Come on, crowd pleaser. Come on, guys. This is unusual. Very unusual. Why are they not doing a final call out? They always do a final call out with even just the top two just to get the crowd going. I'd love to see a final call out with just Tim and Theo. Here we go. Yep, here we go. Oh, come on. So Theo. Theo Le Guerrier, Le Grand Fromage, Roman Fritz, Vlad. Is there one more? Oh, God. Tim wasn't. I thought Tim wasn't top three. So this is the top four. This is the top four. Come on, Lauren. I'm going to go. Oh, I can't decide between Tim and Theo.
I'll tell you what. You go with Tim. I'll go with Theo.
Oh.
And together.
Look. They called Tim first to go in the middle. Now they're going to move. I think they're going to move Theo. Oh, no. They're not moving Theo. Okay.
Well, just
I think
it time.
Lauren, I think this means they've got Theo winning. And then they've got Tim in second, Vlad in third, Roman in fourth. Now, sometimes this can mean that Theo's going to get knocked down to like fourth. This happened to Nathan D'Ascio at the 2021 Prague show, and they moved Nathan to the end, and I said no, it's because they've already decided Nathan is the winner, and it wasn't. Nathan got fourth. So because I messaged Nathan after the prejudging, and I said, oh yeah, you've won that, mate. And he says no, he said they've got me in fourth. Did you see where they put me? And I said yeah, but I thought that was because they'd already decided who the winner is, and they're trying to figure out second, third, and fourth. And well, I was wrong. Nathan was right. So. Dark again. This is tight. This is really tight. This is looking good for Alfred, though. I would love to see Alfred get a third place here. I think he looks, for me, he's a more impressive bodybuilder than Roman Fritz. Roman Fritz, I know, has got the crazy conditioning in the glutes and the hams, but I just prefer the density and the kind of the completeness of Alfred. Tim seems to be holding really well. He's holding his peak really well. Some guys fade, some guys get better, but Tim seems to be really holding his peak. But for me, this is the best Tim Budesheim I've ever seen.
Roman looks good.
He does look good.
I don't know. I don't think he'll take the win, but he looks really good. Nice, tight little waist.
Yeah.
Look at the symmetrical posing. It's beautiful.
I like his, when he does that one hand on the hip, leaning most muscular. It's like you see the width of his shoulders and how, that one there. See that pose there. Here we are. That pose there, really. When he twists as well, he makes his waist go even smaller. Mm. It looks crazy. But for me, I would have Roman in fourth here. And judging on this call out, that's basically where they've got him. But look at Tim. See, when Tim gets his bloody tan and his sheen perfect, look how gets under decent lighting. Right. Here we go. Oh, shit. Is this? Oh, wow.
Yeah, Roman looks great.
Do you think they'll give Roman second?
Roman looks freaking amazing right now.
Do you think they'll give him second?
He looks amazing.
I tell that they like him. He's been getting great placings. I'm not a Roman hater by the way, guys, but I just have my preferences for physiques. Wow. Come on, Theo. We want Theo. We've got to see Theo at the Olympia. The thing is, if the point system was still here, I would imagine that both Tim and Theo would be going to the Olympia because they've had such, you know, they'd be building up a lot of points, but there's no more point system this year. So it's basically a win or you're not in.
Hang on, let me see their glutes.
Yeah, but come on, Roman's got crazy glutes and hams.
Yeah, that's some crazy
glutes. Yeah, but look at the back and the arms. See? And then look at Theo and look at Alfred. See? He's lacking. Just take your eyes away from his ass and his hamstrings. Look at, no, seriously. And then look at like the top to toe physique of Alfred, of Theo, of Tim. He's just got more, they've all got more thickness and development and density. In fact, Tim, I'd give this to Tim. I'd give this to Tim, but I'd be super happy if Theo won as well. But I've just got a feeling just Tim's really nailed it. He's really nailed it. He's so grainy and detailed and everything is showing. He's peaked perfectly. His tan, his sheen, everything. Absolutely fantastic. So yeah, so that's it. So then, Lauren, what do you think? I'm going to go Tim first, Theo second, Alfred third, Roman fourth, but I completely accept that I might be utterly wrong.
I think the fact that they...
Hang on, one sec. Lauren's probably going to be bang on with this and I'm going to be wrong. So just listen to what she's got to say.
I had Theo in first, but considering the fact that they've just moved Tim out...
Yeah.
It is really quite difficult. I think maybe Tim has won it, but I still think Theo for me is... on this day, the best that I've seen.
Hang on, give me your placings. First okay, to fourth.
Okay, fine. I'm going to go with Theo.
Theo first.
But I do think Tim is now going to win because placed him out in fourth.
Come
okay,
on,
fine.
Lauren.
I will go with...
Stick to it. Come on.
I'm trying to be... Okay, Theo.
Theo.
Tim.
Tim.
Roman.
Roman. Vlad.
Vlad. But we might see Tim.
I do you know what? I completely accept that you might be right. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this bit of a live stream review. Like I said, we've done this completely live because I don't like to go and do it after the show because it's a bit of a cop out. Because when we're giving all our predictions, it's if you know the results, then you're obviously going to know, and it kind of takes the whole point of doing this away. Okay then, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this Olympus Pro live stream review. Myself and Lauren Lotter. Okay, guys, we've got the pose down now. So we've got the top five there. The new guy, the new pro turned pro yesterday, the German guy, Matthias, he's made top five. So he's beat Leandro. So let's have a look. Yeah, do you think, Lauren, the posing routine was enough to pull Theo ahead of Tim? Personally, I don't think so.
It was stunning.
It was good.
I was Theo's mom right now, I'd be so proud.
It's good. Yeah, so obviously going down into the crowd now already. So come on, guys, get the lights up. Come on, we're just seeing silhouettes now.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, so hopefully they have another camera angle, which they'll cut to.
Oh, they're going into the crowd!
Yes, I know, Laura, I just said that.
Sorry, guys. I'm so excited when that happens. This is my favourite category.
I know, but they need to get some other camera angles on the go because all we can see is the freaking backdrop on the stage, so...
I think this is one of the best things about bodybuilding shows when they're open guys, they go into the crowd. That is definitely one of the best things.
Okay. Well, also, one of the best things is when they have enough camera angles to cover that. Because right now, all I'm looking at is a freaking hypnotic graphic that's making me a bit hypnotized here.
It's better than the flashing ones from the Olympian 2021.
Yeah, that was very, very flashy.
Too much. Yeah. This is okay. This is quite subtle.
Okay, so we actually finally managed to find another camera angle to get him to get a look at what the guys are doing in the audience there. So obviously hitting the pose down because it's always good fun when they get on the chairs. Careful, Theo, don't fall over. You might crush someone.
Absolutely love it when they get in.
It's cool, isn't it? Cool. Oh, Alfred there getting nice and close to Theo. Yeah, I hope he gets third. I think Roman's got third though.
Roman looks freaking.
I think I'd like to see Alfred get third. I think he deserves it.
Yeah, but it doesn't go by deserving. It goes by the day. I know. So we can't... Unfortunately, this is obsolete.
Okay.
Fair enough. All the guys look amazing.
Looks good. Yeah, it's good.
Absolutely love it when they're
I like I said, I cannot decide between Theo and Tim. I've got a feeling... I think Tim's got the edge, but I wouldn't be surprised if Theo wins it.
Oh, my God. Theo's routine.
It was good. It was good. Very, very good. Well, both Tim and Theo... Theo and Tim, I think they've both nailed it for this show. So I could see each of them being a deserved winner, whoever wins it. It's definitely between those two. And like I said, third and fourth is between Roman and Alfred. Personally, I think Alfred should get third with Roman in fourth. But going on past results, it looks like Roman might get third. Mm. So, but personally, I would have Alfred in third.
Okay, let's watch.
So that Matthias must be so happy with first call out and top five in his first pro show the day after turning pro. So another fantastic new German pro there coming through into the pro league.
He's got incredible shape.
He's good. His condition was very good as well. Posing was very good. So unfortunately, we can't put the sound up because of the copyright with the music and everything will cause us problems on YouTube. So let's see. I can tell you, I think Matthias will be fifth. I think that's fair. And then fourth, it's either going to be Alfred or Roman. Come on. This is tense. This is tense. Oh, come on, Theo. The last chance saloon, guys.
Alfred might get fifth.
I wished I'd dressed the cowboy today, Lauren, because this is the last chance saloon for the Olympia. Fifth place, Matthias. I think he already knows he's fifth. So, but fantastic. Look at that. Yeah, he's buzzing. Tim looks great, though, doesn't he? My God. He does. He looks so good. I think he's won it. I think he's won it. Oh, I don't know. Two number Theo. I can't decide. I cannot decide. There you go. Matthias in fifth. I know nothing about this guy because I didn't follow the amateur show yesterday. So, yeah.
What a weekend for him. It's been a great weekend for him.
Turns, wins, gets his pro card and then makes top five and first call out in the last qualifier for the Olympia. So that must be, he must be so, so happy with that. So yeah, he looks very, very happy. Yep, fantastic. Nice to see new faces coming into the Pro League as well and also doing well from the outset. So yeah, so I'm sure we'll be seeing more of this guy. A little bit more size and but two things I like, a condition and posing, so there's he's got those bases covered. Fourth place, is it Roman or Alfred? Come on. Come on. Come on, you need to change the camera angle, guys. Is it fourth? Alfred, no. Alfred fourth? I think he got fourth. I think I saw his hand go up. Oh, Alfred got fourth. Yeah, I thought so. Yeah, I wanted third for him, Lauren. I did. I think he looked better than Roman. I think he's a more dense, rugged kind of, you know, more of a bodybuilder's bodybuilder for me. But Roman looks fantastic. So Roman's got third there. So that's obviously a, he's obviously going to be happy with that. I think Theo, say that again.
Theo
and Tim will be top two. So third place will be Roman Fritz. I'll bet my roast lamb dinner on it.
Okay.
Okay. Come on. Come on. Third place, Roman. No. Tim.
No.
Tim in third. No. Scandal. What a scandal. No. Oh, no. No, 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 no. No, no. Don't agree with that. Do not agree with that. Absolutely no chance. So Theo's won. Theo's won. Yeah, Theo's won.
Let us not guess until we actually see.
Tim,
we've
no.
got two more places to go.
Either first or second. No, I don't. Oh. This is not good. I don't agree with that. I really am shocked. Very shocked by that. So second place, Roman Fritz. Oh, come on.
Second place, Roman.
Yeah, second place, Roman. It's got to be Theo. It's got to be Theo.
Hang on, let me just watch.
Roman Fritz in second. Oh, Theo looks nervous. Can you imagine their heart must be beating at their chest? Yes, he's got it. Theo's won. Yes. Theo Legrand Fromage wins the Olympus Pro in Milan, Italy. He is going to the O. He's going to his second Olympia. But the good news is Roman Fritz is also going to them because he's already secured his qualification by way of winning the, I think it was one of the Spain shows, NPC European. I think it was early in the season. So, I mean, he's got to be, I mean, obviously Roman wanted to win here, but I think he's going to have to be very, very happy with getting runner up here. So nice little run up to the Olympia and they've got 4 weeks now, but very, very disappointed for Tim. I thought Tim was either first or second. I think he really pushed Theo. And for me, like I said, like I've been saying all during the live stream review, it was a flip of a coin for me. So, yep. So Theo's going to the Olympia. Fantastic. He must be absolutely thrilled. And I think we'll be trying to get Theo on tomorrow for a winner interview, as has become tradition. And, yeah. So big congratulations there to our guy who was obviously on last episode. And, he's happy. Yes. Come on, Theo. Oh, he's buzzing. I'm going to text him, actually. As soon as we finish this, Lauren, I'm going to text him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Congratulations. And his dad. Patrick Le Guerrier. Yay. Oh my God, I'm getting it wrong now. Turning into Ron Harris. Totally butchering his last name. Oh, Tim. Tim's not going to get to the Olympia now. So, well, maybe Tim might do one of the Prague or Romania to try and qualify for next year's Olympia. But yeah, he looked absolutely fantastic. I was really, really impressed with what Tim Budesheim from Germany brought here today. He's been a pro 6 years. I remember when he, I remember seeing him at the 2011 Arnold Europe when he was a junior, and he was huge even then. He was absolutely massive. And then, he's just been a steady rise. First call out with Cedric McMillan, Brandon Curry, and Hadi Schupan in his first pro show when he turned pro at the Amateur Olympia in 2017 in San Marino. And then he ended up taking fourth place the next day, the very next day. Yep, so to those guys with first call out. So, yeah, so, well, fantastic. Right, fantastic show there, Lauren. What did you think?
Absolutely amazing. Congratulations, everyone that took part and that stepped on stage.
You called the win. You called the win. I knew it. I knew you'd be right. Women are always right. That's what something I've been told to say. Right. Okay, then. So, yeah, just have one little final look there at Theo. And, yeah. Go on, Theo. I love him. I love the guy. Yeah. Congratulations, mate. Hopefully you can get to the Olympia and see if you can crack a top 10. And, yeah, so going to his second Olympia.
Awesome. Well done.
Yeah, fantastic. He was sixth, fourth, second, and now he's moved up to first. So that was Italy sixth. Then he went to fourth in Spain. Then he went to second in France behind Dathan Diasha, and he's won this one. So and now he's got. I know he's won in Italy at the Italian Olympus Pro. So anyway, I'll hand it over there to Billy Garnon there. So Theo's obviously very, very happy. So congratulations, Theo Legedia, and we're rooting for you for the Olympia now, mate. So like I said, once again, huge congratulations. Joined all the way from Minnesota with the new Legion Sport Fest champion, Charles Griffin.
Yeah.
The champ is back.
Oh. What's going on?
Mate, I was just saying you should be a supermodel with those cheekbones.
Man, now they about to get more sucked in because we got to get ready for the home, man. They about to get more sucked in.
Oh, but, do you know what, mate? I think your story has to be one of the feel-good stories of the year because, mate, I'll be honest, mate, I was really nervous when I heard that you'd back in April with the injury. And obviously we spoke about it last time about what you went through and, you know, you're thinking, you know, they said they didn't need surgery and, you know, is my career over and the stress you went through. But to kind of pull it out of the bag, mate, and you basically did what Kevin Navrone did in 93.
Yeah, man, you know, I'm not going to lie. When I last interviewed, I was talking real highly. I'm talking like this, I'm talking like that. I had self-doubt. Yeah. I was worried. I was worried and everything like that, you know. And even when I went out there for the 30-second presentation, I was still, like, in my head about everything. And then I text my fiance, like, how'd I look? And she like, you look great. But, of course, she's going to tell me that. You know what I mean? And then I had another friend there, and they sent me a video of me on prejudging. I was like, holy shit, that's me. And then my girl sent me some pictures. Yeah. My girl sent me pictures. I'm like, okay, I do look good. And then Matt told me, you're rushing your poses. He's like, you're the big dog there and act like it. And I told him, okay, watch. And I'm going to go back on that stage and a different animal came out. Yeah. So, yeah.
I mean, I'll be honest. I knew you were nervous because 6 weeks out, your cheeks were like that.
Yeah.
I knew that was like, okay, he's really trying to play all his strengths here, all his cards. Because normally I've never seen you in that kind of condition that sharp, that far out. Yeah. And I thought, okay, he's really, really going all in for this one.
Yeah, we're going all in, you know what I mean? And like I said, like the pec, yeah, you could see the difference on the pec. It really messed with me on the front last spread. But I don't know if you checked my story today where I posed my front last spread. And now I know how to make it flat, how I can hit the front last spread with showing the symmetry. It's totally different now. And it's just trial and error. You know what I mean? I got on that stage and I flexed the pec real hard.
Yeah.
And it showed. Bunched up.
Yeah.
But now this morning, if you go look on my story, when you repost this, I can send you the picture so you can post it up on your videos like you normally do. Yeah. I can send you this picture and you can see how I'm hitting it now. Mm-hmm. And the symmetry's there. You see the little dent where the natural dent is at on my pec, but the symmetry's there. It's not bunched up. That's the only pose that really got to me. When I see that on the social media, that's the only pose that's still messing with me. Even though I won, it's still messing with me. And then after that show, that night, I kept flexing it.
the next day I kept flexing, and I got home, I kept flexing. I'm like, oh, there it is. I don't need to hit it so hard to where it bunches up. Mm. Now it stays symmetry. It's over with now. Now I just gained more confidence going into the Olympia now.
Good. I'll be honest. When I saw the front lat spread, I didn't think it looked that distracting. I could see the tear. I mean, but it to me didn't look. So what you've done is you've just relaxed the muscle. You just haven't flexed it up.
Yes, I just haven't flexed it all the way out.
Yeah.
And I'm flexing the good pec, and it's still, and everything looks good. You know, everybody was like saying, man, you had a pec, it's part of the bodybuilding, this and that. You still look great up there, but me, it's still messing with me.
Yeah.
You know, it still messes with me because I want to deliver. I'm going on the biggest stage of bodybuilding, so I want to deliver. So I started immediately working on how I can make this look better.
Yeah.
And I got it this morning, and I posted it on my story, and I'm like, there we go. I'm just not going to flex it till it's fully engaged to where it tucks all the way over. Now the symmetry's there, and now it's on.
Two things I want to say about that. Look at Hunter Labrada. His best pose is his side tricep, and the side he does is where he shows the pec, but he doesn't flex he lets the pec hang. He doesn't flex it. And that is regarded as his best pose, which is probably the pose that highlights his injury or could highlight his injury the most. And also, many years ago, there was a British bodybuilder, about 20 years ago, and he retired. He was like, he was real international competitor, and he ripped his pec and he said, I'm done. And I saw him at a contest, and I said, he guest posed, and I said, it's just the way you're posing it, mate. I said, when you do your most muscular, like, are you going to do your most muscular, like, crouched over, or are you going to do it where you don't, where you flex the triceps and you just let the chest relax?
How am I going to do it? That's like, I got 24 days to, 24 days to perfect that. I'm going to do the crab because I just looked it gnarly.
Yeah.
But I'm going to see what else looks good. You know what I mean? I'm going to see what else looks good.
Yeah. Honestly, he did it with one hand on the hip, and he, with the pec that was damaged, he just didn't flex it. And he posed around it beautifully. So it can be posed around. And the thing is, it didn't hurt you, mate. You won with straight firsts.
I know, straight first.
And, nice.
And you know, like some of the bodybuilding sides, they're like, it was close, this and that. Not taking anything away from John Jewett. John Jewett's an awesome guy, awesome competitor, this and that, that and that. But from everybody that was in the stands and from everybody that saw the thing, they're like, it was clear cut. And they're like, they say, oh, it's a controversial scorecard, this and that, that and that. Like, they're always going to say something, man. But it's like, man, that was the best condition I ever brought right there. The only thing was the pec. Other than that, that was one of my best looks to date right there.
Charles, I've never seen you out of condition, mate.
I know.
Never once.
It felt very good. It felt very good.
Do you know, I want to give you some credit for the Olympia because you sparked a memory because you took 14th last year. And I was saying in Hot News, we recorded it before this. I said, if you look at who was in the Olympia last year, Derek, Haddy, Brandon, Samson, Andrew Jacked, none of those guys brought their best conditioning. None of those guys were 100% bang on. And I would say in that entire contest, there was probably only two or three guys that absolutely brought the kind of conditioning that I kind of expect to see at the Olympia, and you were one of them.
Yeah, and that's what we're going to bring again. You know what I mean? Like I told Nat, Matt, I just want to come hard as nails, man. Like I want to throw that. Like this show right here, that took out the Olympia clock. That took out the Olympia's conditioning. You know what I mean? That the Legion Sports condition was better than last year's Olympia condition. And if I could bring it better than Legion Sports, I want to bring it better with Legion Sports without losing pop from other body parts, though. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah. So were those, it looks like those three weekly leg workouts paid off.
Oh, they paid off. They paid off. Man, the glutes have never been that solid. My lines in my legs, quads, hamstrings, everything grew. You know what I mean? Everything grew. So it worked out in my favor. It worked out in my favor.
It did. It's like I said, you said, give me grapes, I'll give you wine.
Right. You know what I mean? And that's what I did. You know what I mean? Give me tomatoes, I'm going to make ketchup out of it.
So I want to give some love to Chris Minnisk because that Legion Sport every single year, that show, just when you think the show can't get bigger and better, and I always like to ask the competitors what it's like so other competitors can see and do that show next year because I think the good promoters, they deserve the credit. What was it like competing in an event like that, mate?
dope show, man. It's hands down one of the best shows I've done. How they run it, how they're on time with everything, how everything's boom, 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 how they cater to us, how they make sure we got everything we need. One of the dopest shows I've ever done. It's a very, 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 very random, very good show, that how they run that show.
What would you say, if you were put on the spot, what would you say separates it maybe from, not maybe from other events, but what separates, well, yeah, I suppose it separates from other events.
Just the presentation. The presentation of the whole thing and how everything's like this. They're on time with everything and how they made sure we had everything that we needed. And it was just, you know, they took care of us. It's one of the best ran shows out there, 100%.
Good. Good. No, I just, yeah, they invited me there actually a couple of years ago, but I didn't take the invitation up. So what's the plan for the Olympia now, mate? Obviously, have you spoke to Matt about the game plan on?
Yeah, so we're just back on it. We're back. I started my cardio. I had a meal after the show. I woke up the next morning back on plan, and now we're just back to doing our thing. You know what I mean? I came up a few pounds, you know, just because of the diuretics we take, the water added back on, but nothing to worry about. And now, you know, a couple of days that water be off and we're back to in the ground running. You know what I mean? So it's just like how we're just getting ready for the Legions, just come hard as nails and condition and play my strengths. You know, I'm never going to be the biggest guy on the stage, but I got a lot of dense muscle and I could bring the conditioning, you know what I mean? So, yeah. And when I say the biggest guy, I mean the number on the scale, you know what I mean? I'm never going to be the heaviest guy. So I'm just going to play to my strengths. And my strength is come hard as nails and conditioning with that crazy energy.
So, I mean, obviously, you know, since April, you've had that thing to overcome and, you know, and all the kind of obstacle with the training and then the mental side of it. You've won the show. How's your confidence now? Is it taking an upturn?
Oh, it's taking it up now. Now my confidence is all the way up.
Good.
Especially with how I fixed my front lat spread now. Oh, it's all now. You know what I mean? I'm bringing it. You know, there's a lot of guys that were in the top 10 that's not competing this year, that stepped out this year, and you know what I mean? It's like, why not me? You know what I mean? Like, me and Matt don't miss. Some people's going to miss. And I think my name has been in the game for a while now. And I think I'm finally going to get my real look that I deserve. You know what I mean? Like, they're going to give me my look that I deserve. You're going to have to, because I'm going to bring it. And my energy is going to be like, look at me. Look what we brought. And I'm just going to do what I do, man. But I'm just happy, blessed. Not stressed anymore. It's was real heavy on me. It's real heavy on me because, like, anything could happen. And, like, if it was the beginning, in the middle of the year, I got one or two shows to get my next qualification. This was the last show of the year.
I was just about to say that, last one.
It was like, ugh, I didn't want to come back to my city without that qualification. You know what I mean? And, man, I didn't do it. I came back to my state, came back to my gym with that qualification, man. I'm so happy. I'm on cloud nine right now. All my clients, when they come up, they're like, your energy's kind of scary right now. You look like, you don't look like death. You know what I mean? Like, I was looking like death before I left. Now I come just happy as could be, so it's on now.
What was that?
Emoji.
Okay, some emoji just popped up on the screen. So, I mean, the thing is, there has to be something sweet about that top 10. Sorry, the last qualifier. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's something.
Yeah.
And thing is, then also, you're the freshest in the eyes of the judges. Like, you know,
exactly.
Like, say if you'd have qualified in at a show last year or the beginning of the year, like a few months later, then you're out of people's minds.
I got the buzz going right now. The buzz is going about me right now. You know what I mean?
Tough
it's
show
going
as well.
About me. So. Now I just got to keep riding that horse on to the Orlando, Florida, get away from this cold weather into the sunshine state and enjoy it. You know what I mean? I'm taking it all in, man. This is my third time making it to the big stage, 2018, 22, 23.
Yeah.
It's like, it's on, man. Like, I'm blessed, man. Three-time Olympian, man. Like this workout today, I'm about to go stupid on my back workout today.
Are you
going to be at the Olympia?
I'm not going this year, mate. I'm going. The only one I'm going to now is Prague.
Okay.
Prague. So, and also you got three tracksuits now.
What's that? Yeah, three tracksuits.
With Griffin on it. With Griffin.
I can't wait for this next one. Yes, sir.
So, do you honestly think the top 10 is calling you this year?
I honestly think the time, I thought it was calling me last year,
yeah.
And I really think it's calling me this year. You know what I mean? This is my story, man. This is my story. I got a story. I already told part of my story, how I got into bodybuilding, and then what happened this year. That's part of my story. And my ending of my story is, look what he did. He got into the top 10
yeah.
after what he had. It's my story already. You know what I mean? It's written for me, and I feel like it's obtainable, and I really feel like it's possible for me to do. Everything that we want to do lines up, it's going to happen.
Did you ever consider taking the year off after the injury? Did you think, shit, that's me done for the year?
Yeah, I thought about it. I really thought about it, you know, and I thought about it. And like I said, I think it was my spirit. My mother's spirit was like, hey,
do it.
Do it.
Yeah.
This is what you're supposed to do. And I was like, this is what it is. And I'm doing it. It lined up. October 3rd was my mom's birthday. October 8th, I won the show. And then today, as I'm interviewing you with you, this is the day God called my mom up for a bigger story. You know what I mean? Today was the day my mom passed away years ago. So it's like, it's my story. It's meant for me to happen. You know, it was meant for me. Like I always say, I can guarantee if she was here, I wouldn't be living this life, Giles. I would be worrying my mama on me being in the streets doing something stupid. You know what I mean? So with her, like, you know, with her not being here, I had to live life differently so she didn't worry up there. You know what I mean? And this is what I'm doing right now. On the day that she passed away, I'm talking to you about me going to the Olympia for the third time.
Wow.
And talking about me getting in the top 10. Why not me?
Yeah.
Why can't that be part of my story? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And I feel like I'm writing my story this year, and I feel like it's about to happen.
I was, because I on Sunday, I was covering the Italy show, the live stream. So yep. I heard that your speech was fantastic when you won.
Go ahead.
Yeah, because I saw you hashtagging Mama's Boy, and obviously you dedicating the win to her and everything, and the show and the prep, and you know, it's like dedicating the whole thing to her. So I heard that your speech was really touching.
Yeah, you know, I let people know about my mother, and then I just give props to like the fans, the audience in the stage, the people that follow me on Instagram, all the likes. I was just letting everybody know without them, we don't have this Legion Sports. We don't have this bodybuilding. What I'm doing right here with you, if we don't have viewers, if we don't have these fans of the sport, we can't have none of this. So I was just thanking all of them for, you know, allowing us to do this, because without them, we can't do this. You know what I mean? So yeah. That's where I was just giving, you know, praise to where it's due. You know what I mean? And that's not that wasn't just to me because I'm winning the show. No, it's because of the viewers, it's because of the promoters, it's because of all the people that's doing that. It's the reason why I'm able to do this. So that's what it is.
Well, I mean, I was so happy when you won, because obviously I followed your story and we spoke a few weeks ago, and I was just like, wow, he did it. He freaking did it. He left it right to the last minute, kept us all like, you know, all really nervous. And thinking, oh, no. And, you know, and you did it, mate. You did it, you know. And I mean, even just to sort of compete this year was a win in itself. So to see you actually win as well and get to the Olympia, you know,
it was like a double win.
Yeah,
it was like a double win.
I know, because the thing is, it wasn't one of those shows where it was after the cutoff and you were qualifying for next year. It's like, shit, you left it right to the last minute, and now you've got 4 weeks of like.
And it wasn't a small show. It was It was like 28 athletes in there, 28 bodybuilders in there.
Yeah.
Like when we went in there for the athletes meeting, I'm like, holy shit, this is a lot of people. Mm. And I sat there and I talked to my girl and I was like, I'm gonna be honest with you. This pec is bothering me right now. I'm not as confident because I usually go in with my glasses. Not like shades, but my cool man glasses. I usually do all this and do all that, but I didn't do my normal thing because I wasn't as confident. Mm. And I told her about that, and then she started giving me a hyped up speech, this and that. And I was like, I don't need that right now. I know what you're saying, but I'm just being vulnerable with you and I'm talking to you. And she's like, I know, but I'm telling you what I feel. And I talked to Matt the same thing before the athletes meeting, and Matt told me some stuff, and he was like, and both of them saying some stuff where I'm like, you guys are not hearing me. Yeah, they were hearing me, but I wasn't hearing them. And You know, she told me, I want you to walk into that athletes meeting. My fiance told me, I want you to walk in that athletes meeting like you always do with your head up and confident, this and that. And, you know, I walked in there, but I didn't feel as confident. You know what I mean? I'm going to be honest with you. I didn't feel as confident. I didn't feel as confident until after I did my 30-second presentation, when they sent me some videos and pictures and I talked to Matt. And when I saw that, and I was like, oh, shit. now they about to see Charles Griffin, the definition, come out to play now. Now when I went out there with the in the groups of five and this and that, now I was like, I brung my energy. And that's when I became confident when I got on that stage the second time. The whole weekend, this whole year, me getting ready, the confidence was nowhere, man. I'm going to be honest with you. I put on a good front, you know what I mean? And, you know, and that's what I had to do. But now the confidence is at an all high right now. Now I'm riding that horse, you know what I mean?
Well, props to you for your mental strength to get through what you've been through this year and to kind of, you know, overcome it and succeed. And also props to your fiance and Matt Jansen for kind of probably being there for you when you were at your lowest and to give you a bit of a, and pick you up, do you know what I mean? And kind of keep you moving forward.
Yeah. I want to apologize on here to my fiance about getting mad at her a couple times when I'm feeling a certain type of way about this, and I'm feeling like she's feeding me some BS, but she wasn't feeding me no BS. She was really being serious. So I'm apologizing on here to her. So when she watches, she's gonna be like, "Oh, you apologize?" Yeah.
Nice. Well, you're in the good books now, mate.
Yes, sir. So, well, I think that's all I want to say, mate.
I wanted to congratulate you, because that was huge, mate. I was very, very excited when I saw that. I was just like, oh my God, he did it.
Yes.
So, because I knew how much this year meant to you for so many reasons, you know?
Yes. Appreciate you, Giles. You always, man. That's why I was like in the airport. I was like, you want to do the interview on me in the airport? I'm going to try to make it happen. Like anybody else, I would have told them, yeah, let's do it on Tuesday. Let's do it on Wednesday.
Yeah.
I was going to try to make it happen for you in the airport, man. Like I always appreciate you, man. I always appreciate your love and support, brother. I truly do, always.
Well, it worked out great because when you text me, I was actually texting you at the same time to say our Wi-Fi had gone down.
Yeah.
And then this morning, it fixed itself. And we've got a perfect picture. So everything worked out.
Man, like over here, Matt wanted that. We had bad places. The Airbnb didn't have good lighting, so I had to drive to the gym to take pictures. And the second time I drove to the gym, we walk in the gym and they're like, "We're closing up in 2 minutes." And it was like, "Holy shit, we made it just in time!"
Nice.
And I got those pictures, the gnarly pictures. And then I was about to go get tan, and then my girl was like, "You forgot to do your baking soda and dish soap thing." And I was like, oh, like everything just happened. Boom, boom, boom.
What?
Like how, and then me and you, how it just happened. Boom, boom. Everything's supposed to happen the way it's supposed to happen. And my story.
Hang on, man. What's this baking soda and dishwasher thing?
Oh, yeah. So, you know, this is my thing, man. You know what I do? Like I tell people, like everybody, like your skin preparation for a week. I don't do none of that.
Oh, so you don't drink it. You don't drink it then.
No, I don't drink it. What I do. So what I do is I get.
So you get big muscles, guys. Seriously.
I'm talking about an hour, 2 hours before I go. I get baking soda with dish soap, and I make a paste.
Yeah.
And I put it all over my body.
Exfoliator.
And when I rinse that off, your skin is dry as could be, and the tan just sticks to you.
Charles.
Like I got the big tanning companies out here that use it, that do it. All my athletes do it. It's the best thing you could do.
You've just given away a huge secret there, and maybe a possible advantage to your competitors. Do you want me to edit this out?
It's all, yeah, edit that out. Edit that part out.
Charles, mate, I'm going to let you go, mate, but thank you so much, as always, for... I really appreciate, you know, and obviously, you know, right after, because I tell you what, some of the guys before the Olympia, they're saying no to all interviews. Some of them are. And like, you're like, yeah, come on, let's do it. So I really do appreciate that, mate.
Like I said, without all this, it ain't nobody building. So I'm never too good to do this type of stuff. I enjoy this type of stuff. You know what I mean? So.
Cool.
We're here, Giles. We made it.
Well, back to your beef and peanut butter and brown rice now, mate.
Yeah, no brown rice, white rice.
Oh, white rice, sorry.
We don't Wow. Yeah, we don't do that brown stuff. No.
Can't chew it. It's too dry, isn't it? It's too dry.
Yeah, that's too dry.
Yeah. Just put some extra. What do you put up? What the Reese's peanut butter eats?
Oh yeah, that's always with me. I got that in my back pocket right now.
Right, well, all right then, mate. Well, as always, like I said, thank you so much for coming to Eagle & Muscle, and congratulations once again, mate. I'm really, really happy for you.
Thank you, brother. Appreciate you.
All right, I'll speak to you very soon, mate, and all the best for the next 4 weeks.
All right, thank you.
Take care, mate. Okay, guys, welcome to MD Globe Muscle Season 5, Episode 50 of Hot News. I forgot the name of it there. I'm joined today on a Tuesday, not a Sunday. Who is on the mic today, Lauren?
Puff Bombshell.
Kind of gave it away there, I said Lauren.
Oh.
So anyway, yeah, we're actually filming a bit late this week because the two guests we had on were competing on Sunday. They both won their contests. Monday they were traveling back, and so we got them today, and that's why Global is being released one day late. So we're back in our normal slot. Also, Lauren, might have an in studio guest potentially. No promises on Sunday.
Oh,
for episode 51. I think all I'll say is that we may actually melt the bleep machine.
Yeah, my mother's gonna be here to meet this person.
Lauren, take her out for a walk. Thing is. What was I going to say?
The bleep machine guest.
Oh, no. What it is, apparently, if you don't swear in the first 30 seconds, it helps the algorithm. So I'll just have to do the talking for the first 30 seconds.
How do you not swear for 30 seconds, though?
I can not swear for 30 seconds. I'm not sure this person can. Do you remember I warned you about him last time?
Yeah, so it was hilarious.
And I thought you were going to be horrified, and you just went, that was brilliant. That was absolutely fantastic. Got to get him back again.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of this person's Instagram.
Yeah, so I hope he turns up.
Me too.
Oh, no, I'm such an idiot if he doesn't turn up. Right, okay, obviously this week, there's two final qualifiers for the 2023 Olympia. We had the Legion Sport in Reno, Nevada on Sunday. And also we had the Olympus Pro in Milan, Italy, by obviously the IFBB Pro League Italy, Barbara Bagnuolo, Barbara Doll, known as on Instagram. Two fantastic shows on the same day. So obviously the American team and us UK guys over here for MD were kind of sort of, you know, keeping a track and watching the live stream and seeing what was what. And obviously you've seen the live stream review, which we did live. You've got to do it live. Mm. If you replay it later and you know the results, what's the point of giving commentary?
I do that all the time.
What do you mean?
That's what I do.
No, you don't. No, if you're recording something. Oh, yeah, but you know the results.
That's the point.
No, we don't know the results when you're doing the live stream review when it's live.
Okay, when it's live, you get better reaction and it's more fun. But when it's non-live, it's more detailed.
Well, the thing is, I mean, I'm not. Otherwise, I'm going to go, I think Theo's got this one. I think Charles has got this one.
It's more like a detailed breakdown and analysis if it's not live. Or if it's live, it's more about reaction and about timing.
I suppose it's a different sort of review, isn't it?
Yes.
Also, talking of live stream review, should we talk about that at the end?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Okay, right, okay, we're going to go straight into Theo Leguerrier for the Grand Fromage. How cool was it when his dad rang?
Oh, he's sweet, yeah.
Patrick Leguerrier literally rang me soon as obviously the live stream had finished and Theo, his son, had won. So that was really, really cool. He goes, thank you for... He said it in like broken English. He said, thank you for support or something. That was really cool. But and I checked on my Instagram later and he tried ringing me on Instagram as well. Aww. So he's obviously trying to get through to me to share the sort of, you know, the celebration. So I thought that was really, really cool. So yeah, so Theo is going to his second Olympia. I'm very, very happy about that. You watched the live stream. Of course, he did the live stream review. He deserved it, didn't he?
Fantastic. The routine blew me away.
I had a little. So you get a little teary eyed again when you watch his routine.
I was almost crying. It's I don't know. He's just so soulful.
Yeah, he is. He's cool.
For me, for Sean Clarita and his routine, very like a performance.
Yeah. Yeah. I spoke to Patrick Tour as well, who was there, because obviously he had Alfred Vlad Kiriak in his show, and he obviously he wanted better for Alfred because Alfred got fourth. He had Alfred second, and Patrick's a very good coach, very good judge, very good, you know, assessor of the sport. Maybe a little bit too biased maybe to his own guys, but I thought Alfred looked fantastic. But he said that Theo fully deserved it, because I said if you watch the live stream review, Patrick comes out on Thursday or whatever, I said, I keep flip-flopping, and I said it on the Power Hour today, which we filmed today, which will be out by the time you watch this, with Ron Harris. And I obviously, I was probably, 60-40 towards Tim winning? And I was like, oh, Theo, Tim Budesheim, Theo Legerier. I couldn't decide. Do you remember? We only filmed it 2 days ago.
Yes. God.
So yeah, so I mean, and Patrick said, well, you know, he said no, he said that was fair. He said, in fact, he had Alfred second and Tim third, and I don't know what Roman. He must have had him fourth or fifth. So obviously, the result it shows you how close all the European guys are, because I mean, Theo from Italy, Spain, France, and now Italy again. He's gone sixth, fourth, second, first. And he's beaten all the guys that beat him in the first few shows, because Roman beat him, Tim Budesheim beat him, Alfred didn't beat him. Yeah, so they just kind of, some guys get better, some guys get worse. Also, you have different head judges as well. So so there's that. So anyway, let's quickly go through Theo's Instagram. He's only literally got back, was it today? Yesterday. Well, he voice messaged me today. And he said, yes, he could do tonight. And he was training. He was very out of breath. And I thought, oh, no, he's going to cancel.
No.
And then he says, no, that's fine. Because we tried to get him yesterday, but it wasn't. Well, the Wi-Fi went down yesterday, didn't it?
Actually, that was a bit of good luck for us, because it wouldn't have been, we would have had to cancel.
Why? Because he went, oh, yeah, of course, yeah. I was about to say, I thought because he wanted to go to the gym.
No.
No, so anyway, yeah. So, yeah, our Wi-Fi went down. And then somehow this morning it all started working again. So, yeah, save me going into town and farting about with that. So anyway, quickly, let's have a look at Theo. This was yesterday, I'm assuming, when he got back. So he's only 4 weeks out now from the Olympia. It's the very last qualifier. So he really, really got in there just in the nick of time, because obviously Theo was at the Olympia last year and he's back this year. And I think of Theo, you know, like I said in the Power Hour today in the Olympia reviews, he's one of those guys like Andrea Presti, another European, that you know is going to turn up in condition, you know he's going to be polished, you know he's not going to miss the mark, because I've never ever seen Theo off. I mean, that is a hell of an achievement. To me, that's as impressive as winning multiple pro shows, which he has done as well now. He's won two pro shows now. All right?
Sorry, I'm distracted by Theo's shreds.
Just looking at Theo's lower lats.
Yeah, I was just...
Yeah, have a look.
Very
look at him.
Good.
He's awesome, isn't he? Oh, so cool. I remember when I did that and come back in the striations of the lats. It's so cool. So, yeah, so I'm really, really excited for Theo to get to his second Olympia. He didn't place top 15 last year. So, really, I'd love to see him just get in that... I'll be honest. I'd love to see him get that 11th to 15th.
I was just going to say 12th to 8th for me.
And 12th then,
weight. Yeah, like...
Oh, you think he gets 12th?
I do, yeah. I think anywhere from that region, and then he carries on going.
Yeah, true. Can you put it on full screen, please, Lauren?
Absolutely.
So you got to go see Theo's back in full screen. Come on. There you go. There we go. Look at that. Awesome. Yeah, he's just very, very, very pleasing physique, very balanced. And like I said, he's always in condition. So... Let's have a look at another quick video. So here he is, the winner. Yeah, but it must be such a relief when you've done multiple shows and obviously the pressure from the sponsors and everything else. It must be such a relief to finally get that qualification. So these are Jonathan Morio's photos, of course. Fantastic photographer who sorts me out with my pictures for my columns and a lot of my articles and everything. So are you switching?
I am switching. Okay. Don't you worry.
Okay. Just checking. Oh, he's getting dark already. Look, bloody hell. There he is, Roman Fritz, who's second place. He's already qualified for the Olympia, so he's going. He won a show in Spain back in the, I think it was a big man weekend, beating Emir Omuradjic early in the summer. So he's already qualified. So it would have been a real bummer if Theo had got second here, because then, you know, like Nathan doing his second show, taking the opportunity from somebody else, you know, but that's how the sport is, unfortunately, you know. But there's nothing to stop bodybuilders doing multiple pro shows, even if they've won. So let's have a look. Yeah, there he goes. Yes, I won it. I'd be going to the, I actually swore when I won my first show.
I believe you.
Yeah, I just I won't say what I saw. I won't say what I said. Anyway, yeah. So there, yeah, Theo. Obviously, the look of a very happy Frenchman there. So, because the thing is, we were going to film last night, but he was going out for a meal with his family. Yeah, so. So he said, I've got a meal for my family, Gilles. Anyway, I'll look. Who's this guy here? I don't know this guy. I feel like I recognize him. Is that one of the German guys? I don't know. Yes, he's, look, he's got a really nice, complete physique. Very pleasing. And do you know, he's only, what, 30?
Yeah, he's really progressed in the last 2 years since I've known him on the scene.
Yeah.
He's just incredible.
Yeah. It's pointless going back any further because we had Theo on last week and we've gone through all these posts. And this is from France. That's from France. That's from the first Italy show where he was sixth. So, and he's, like I said, he's been in condition for every single one of them. Prepped by Mauro Sassi. So, yeah, so absolutely fantastic there. Congratulations there to Theo for winning. Let's have a look at this. It's in French. Do you want me to read it?
No.
Du champion au champion, découvre. Oh, it's a supplement stack. Let's have a look. Okay, here we are. Good. Well, you got to promote the sponsors. He said pimp then. You got to promote the sponsors. You know, because obviously Yamamoto is really, really supporting a lot of very good athletes in Europe. They've got Nathan, him. Is Regan, I think, at Regan? No, he's Canadian. He's Yamamoto. We've got a Yamamoto product. I don't even know what it is.
No, I don't know. I keep looking at it and I never know what to do with it.
What happened? Why don't we want it or something? Do you want a goodie bag?
From Sweden. What are we?
Glycoload or something.
We need to get the name of it and have everyone tell us because we don't know what it's for and it's just...
Normally you can tell from the name or the text and I'm like...
No, I don't know what it's
for. I actually don't know how I'm supposed to use this. That's crazy, but a fantastic company. Cherry Pure. I started Cherry Active stuff. I was telling you about the Montmorency cherries. Good for anti... I used to put it in my post-workout drink. And it's very, very good for anti-inflammatory. Very good for recovery. For recovering free radicals and all that. Yeah, antioxidant. Very, very, very potent antioxidant. That's why I like to eat cherries.
Okay.
At night. With a glass... neck down with a glass of wine. Right, okay then. I think we've seen enough there on Theo. But like I said, I'm really happy for you, mate. Really excited for you to get to the Olympia. And I really want to see you in that... top 15 now because you deserve to move up now. There's 19 guys because a lot of guys have dropped out or like Valier who's retired and some of Kamal's not doing it because he obviously was in Libya, won the Masters Olympia. Then you've got guys like Rami's out. Do you know what I mean? So obviously the names are on the list because they're qualified, but we went through it all in the Power Hour, so go check that out, myself and Ron Harris. Okay, I'm gonna go to Charles Definition Griffin. I'm equally, if not more, happy for Charles because of the injury he went through this year. Mm. I mean, that pec tear was absolutely... back in April, he actually thought, is my career over? And I can't imagine the mental strength it takes to come back from that. That's absolutely incredible. And as you can see, he wasn't showing the pec. See, like, posts like this where he's kind of keeping his top on, you know? See, he was showing off the legs because he said when he ripped his pec, having Global a few episodes ago... When he ripped the pec, he couldn't train. He just decided to train legs three times a week and bring his legs up.
Gee,
it's incredible, isn't it?
Well, the legs look amazing.
Look at that! He's really brought them up. The thing is, I mean, even what was this? How many weeks out? Well, that was 1 week out. But I've seen videos of him at 4, 5, 6 weeks out, and he had the cheekbones, the sharp cheekbones. So you could see that he was. Oh, looking a bit dark now. Could you lighten me up, please? Thank you. Let's have a look. But so happy for Charles. Obviously, saw him in the... it wasn't in that. That was the Olympus Pro. But here's some pictures from the Legion Sport. I kind of feel like maybe he didn't over diet, but I think he really... I think he could have come in a little bit fuller, but I think he just decided to just shoot for conditioning, purely for conditioning, which was a smart move because obviously won him the show straight firsts. Beating John Jewett first time in the Open, Justin Rodriguez, who's been a top 10 Olympia guy. I mean, John Jewett's been fourth at the 2019 212 Olympia, so he's a top Olympia guy, really, technically. So I'd like to see Charles just come a little bit fuller, but with that same conditioning. I know it's a tricky balance to get that right, but I think Charles and Matt Jansen can get this right. So, as you can see there, he's hiding the pec. That's how you hide the pec, you know? Whereas if he did a stood up most muscular, you'd see the pec more. I don't know. It's, I mean, Hunter Labrada, Tony Freeman, these are top pro bodybuilders that, you know, have been fourth, fifth in the Olympia, that pec test has not held their careers back. So, you know what I do?
Well, can't you get surgery on your pec and stuff?
He didn't get surgery. They said they wouldn't do it. They said it wasn't, he explains it in Global when he was on a couple of weeks ago. But he didn't get surgery. So
maybe it was a minor tear and he's had correct it. I don't know. I don't know anything about pecs.
There's a difference between muscle tears and tendon tears. If you have the tendon tear, you have to have it reattached.
Ooh.
But if it's a muscle tear, you just let it heal. So that's what they did here with Charles.
And his was a muscle tear.
A muscle tear, yeah, but it was a nasty one. It was a real nasty one. Have you ever heard anyone tear a muscle in the gym?
Only, no, and I really hope I never ever hear it.
Oh, do you know what? I'm just thinking about that video from Ryan Crowley. Remember he did the incline?
Yeah.
And oh my God, I remember using that clip and editing into Global, and I remember every time it was on a loop, watching it and playing it and you know, obviously whilst I was doing editing, you have to play it a few times. I mean, I had to scroll through it because it went through me every single time. It's absolutely brutal. And I can't imagine the fear it creates when it actually happens, when it goes, because you're just thinking, oh no. I mean, God, jeez. Anyway, well, it worked out. He did it. He won in a very, very toughly contested show at the Legion Sport. Look at these guys. Damn! Looking good, champ. I like it when I see other pro bodybuilders from the same category putting genuine comments on. Like, you know, like supportive comments. I think that's really cool. You get a lot more of that in classic than you do in open. All the classic guys support each other. Let's have a look.
I feel like that's the same with the fitness.
Really? Yeah.
The fitness ladies are really supportive of each other.
Why is that, do you think? As opposed to other classes. Do you think bikini girls are very supportive of each other, or do you think they're a bit bitchy?
You know, no comments. I've gone to a lot of trouble for certain things, so I'm not commenting on bikini.
I'm going to cancel you, Lauren.
Let's move on.
We were just talking about that, because obviously the Rami thing that's posted today.
Oh, yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Obviously with Israel, Palestine, it's huge news at the moment. And obviously certain countries support different, you know, other countries from whatever. So it's getting a bit... I just hope that doesn't blow up more than it does. Because, you know...
What, the situation or the athletes?
No, the situation with the athletes as well. And I hope Paddy Chupan says nothing. Because, no, they are loyal to whatever they're loyal to. They're, you know, that's what they believe. And
of course, but, like, you can't... It's up to the supplement companies and all of them to decide what is in their values and then what athletes they want on their team. But you can't change that.
I know. I just, I don't know. I mean, I suppose if they've got a platform to speak and they've got thoughts and feelings, then why not speak about it? I mean, it's up to them. I mean, if there's any backlash, that's on them, you know? But the thing is, it's a very passionate subject that people are passionate about on both sides, feeling like they're in the right, the others are in the right, and whatever. So obviously it goes back decades. So, well, let's see what happens. I hope nothing sort of untowards happens and it all dies down. But anyway, back to Charles Griffin. like I said, there's not much more to say really. But just congratulations to Charles Griffin. So happy for him. Charles always brings the condition. Now, he's obviously qualified for the Olympic because he was there in 18. He was there in 18. Was it 21? 22 or is it 2019? He actually wrote it down, and and he's dedicating this to his mother as well, who died. I like Charles. He's a cool guy, as you've seen in this episode. Like I said, we haven't actually recorded with him yet, but I know he's going to be cool because Charles is cool. And he was 14th place last year. I thought he was a bit hard done by last year. I thought he was actually one of a small handful of competitors that actually brought really, really, really good conditioning, because he's not even Haddy, Derek, Samson, Brandon. Nick was in shape, but those guys in the top six, none of them brought their best condition. So there was guys like Charles who were in 14th place who really did bring their best condition, who looked absolutely sensational. So I'd love to see him get higher this year. I'd love to see him get... I don't know whether he could... Could he crack top 10? He could. For me, the top 8-9 is pretty... I've got it pretty locked in my mind of where that is. But yeah, I could see him getting in the top 10. And obviously the pec hasn't seemed to, they haven't seemed to mark him down for it because the rest of his package is so strong. So anyway, we're going to quickly go to Bodybuilders Without Borders. I want to show you this guy. Check this guy out, Lauren. This guy is like Bonac 2.0. He's...
beautiful, yeah.
And he's not classic because I know it looks like he's wearing classic shorts, but this is the other side of the...
No.
Yeah.
Yes, I see the logo, yeah.
No. So I think it's surely if this guy's got any sense, he's going to come over to the pro league. And I'm guessing he'd be 212.
What country is this show in?
I don't know. I think it might be the Middle East or something, because they make him wear the shorts. This is what Andrew Jack had to wear when he competed. And you think, my God, that's a big classic. So, I mean, this guy is incredible. I just wish he had the trunk. I mean, you can see the glute striations through his bloody... Look, see his glute striations through his trunks. But here's a guy that I think... I mean, I can't see anybody beating him in a 212 show.
Well, he can cross over really nicely.
Imagine if he was like 210, 215 or something. I mean, look at him. Even his cheeks have got muscles. Look at me. Look at him. He's flexing the pecs. But it's clean. It looks clean, doesn't it? It looks...
Everything's very symmetrical.
It looks like a cartoon character. It looks photoshopped.
It looks great, yeah.
And he's dry. He's detailed. Come on, mate. Get yourself over to the Pro League. Get yourself over. Get your ass over. Because I'm not saying you're wasting your time over there. But, I mean, I imagine you hit the ceiling. Because I can't imagine there's anyone over that side that will give this guy any hassle. And I bet he's even more impressive in the flesh as well. So I am so impressed by this guy. So I really hope he comes over to the Pro League, and I really hope that he's kind of hovering around the 212, because if he does, he is going to win multiple pro shows next year, because this guy is a genetic marvel. I think he's incredible. I mean, this guy could do open. Look at him. He's not lacking anything. Do you know what? I'm actually struggling to find a fault on this guy. He's going to put me out of a job. Seriously, look at that. I mean, there's not anything I can really criticize him on, apart from the shorts.
Yeah, I was just going to say, if he's got different shorts,
look at his delts.
Have a better look at his glutes.
Lauren, look at his shoulders. Yeah. My God, I'm just going crazy for this guy.
Yeah, Giles
absolutely
is
man-crushing. Awesome. Man-crushing, yeah. So, right, we're going to quickly look at... obviously, yeah, we have... Oh, bad. Brett Wilkins at the Olympia.
No,
Yeah, he's at the Olympia. He said his body wasn't responding. I think it's a health thing or whatever, But he's been training since Romania. Sorry, he did got second Romania to Beirut, and then he went on to Spain and got the qualification last November for this year's Olympia in November. So he's had a full year and 4 weeks out. Now he's pulled out. So I still don't know what the exact reason is, but I just feel bad for him. You know, I mean, he's got a new baby and everything, and he said his body wasn't responding the way he wanted it to. But he must be very disappointed to be pulling out in 4 weeks. So I just wish him all the best and hope to see him. I'd like to see him hopefully we'll see him in the Isles in March, and hopefully we'll get to see him, you know, at his best and show off all the gains he's made in the last year, because he must be absolutely devastated. But I'm sure he's made the right decision for him and his wife and his child. And, you know, like I said, I didn't watch all the video that he posted. It just all I knew is that he's out. So I'm just looking for the squirrel again. I've been putting nuts out for him today. And honestly, I went into the bathroom, had a shower, came back, and all the nuts were gone from the garden.
We have a new pet squirrel.
Errol.
Errol.
Errol the squirrel. I'm going to tame him as well. I'll tame him. Because I had a whole place back to 2011, and I had, and it was in this conservatory, and they used to see me, and they come down, and I used to give them nuts, and it took me about a year, and eventually they were eating out of my hand.
Oh.
Anyway, back to Brett Wilkin. Right, okay then. Yes, just trying to think what else there was. Oh, also, this guy. I mean, I know I don't really cover men's physique much, but he beat... This guy beat the current Olympia physique champion.
This guy is good.
Yeah, but he beat... Is it Aaron Banks? Is it Aaron Banks? Yeah, he beat him.
Well, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, he beat him. So, the plot twist. Hang on, where is it? Yeah, so he, hang on, but he beat last year's Olympia champ. So the Olympia champ came in to do this as like a warm-up show, pick up some prize money, and, you know, why not get a win, do a good show, probably local to him, and he gets beat by this guy.
And this is at Legion.
Yeah, so it really adds a lot of excitement for the Olympia. Mm. Really does. So...
Well, anything can happen in 4 weeks.
There you go.
Hang on, let me just close up.
Hey, he really beat him. Can you imagine that?
He looks chuffed, though. Look how happy he
looks. Lauren, I mean, this is the equivalent of...
Yeah, me winning over Ashley Godwin.
No, this is the equivalent of Charles Griffin doing the Legion and Haddy saying to Hanny, because he's over in Texas at the moment, hey, should we, fancy doing the Legion. Can we just jump in and do it? Hanny says, okay, then let's do it. And then he goes to get beat by Charles Griffin. That's the equivalent.
Well, they both look absolutely great. But, you know, like anything can happen. It's all about who is the best person on the day.
Yeah.
Men's physique, I... love it.
And not
I think it's so
and not
I think
a
so much
single
fun.
Calf was trained.
No, like
maybe I'll do
calves.
Men's physique.
You know what? I do think that you should maybe come back eventually.
No.
Yes.
Not with my old scars everywhere, bloody.
It will look amazing.
I know I look rugged with my scars. But anyway, quickly, I want to show you this last video of... look at Darren Lunsford. But Lauren...
Oh, my God.
I think he's going to win. I think he could win.
That is crazy.
I'm copping out now. I'm saying he will win, and I'm saying he could.
That's amazing.
I think him, Haddy, Samson, and Brandon will be the top four. And I think any one of those four could win it. Shaking your head there, Lauren?
What about Nick Walker?
Ah, you love Nick. Now, sixth place.
I tell you,
he's out of the top 10 this year.
Well, I tell you what, Derek looks absolutely amazing now that we just, like, let's just put it look the at focus that. Back on him over here.
He's just a monster.
He looks amazing.
I mean, God, it's incredible, isn't he? Look at that back.
That's amazing.
Do you remember when he came out last year and he just came out and he hit the front relax and everyone just gasped?
Everyone went wild.
Well, I did. Bloody hell, I went crazy, like, holy shit, he delivered. He does, you know, belong in the open, you know? Ends up getting second to Haddy Shoup on an absolutely incredible show, absolutely incredible memory. So there you go. He's looking huge, isn't he? He's just, yeah, he's awesome. Monster. Because obviously Hanny's thing is, Hanny Rambod, his coach, has got him and Haddy. So he's got one and two. Mm. So it must be tough trying to give equal attention. Nah, these guys are professionals. So anyway, right, okay then. Oh, shit, what happened there? Ooh, yeah. Right, I want to quickly show this photo of Charles Griffin. So you can see the pec. Do you think it doesn't look too bad, Lauren, do you think? Or be honest.
You know, I can see it now that you pointed it out. Mm-hmm. And there is a little bit of a discrepancy.
It's like a dent.
But, you know, from the side, this looks great.
Mm-hmm.
Looks good.
Yeah.
Keep it going. That looks great.
Lauren, look at the stripy delts.
I like the stripes.
Beautiful.
That looks great.
Beautiful. I've seen this back fuller. I think he really, really, really just wanted to get dry as possible. But I've seen him fuller than this. But the conditioning was on. It was enough to win. He's got his qualification. So I would definitely like to see Charles Griffin a little bit fuller. I can't imagine what he's gone through, you know, having that injury and then coming back and then winning, you know, and obviously the last qualifier in America. It's a real good feel-good story because I think, you know, a lot of bodybuilders would have been completely, you know, their heads would have been completely done in by this. So I really do respect him for, you know, coming back like this and winning. So, it takes real kind of mental fortitude.
Mm.
Testicular fortitude, we call it.
No, Charles.
Well, okay. That's what I call it. Right, okay then. Okay, guys. Also, please do not forget to check out the latest issue of MD where there was Samson Dowder on the cover. He still hasn't received his 10 copies yet because I want this one. I'm going to send this one to him and I'm going to get him to sign it like my Brandon Curry and Phil Heath covers.
He needs to get those framed.
I know. I want to put them up there, up this wall here. So it looks really cool when the guests come on and they see how cool we are. Right, we got to go because we've got a guest. So I know. I'll be checking my watch. Don't worry. I'm on the case. I've got my phone here. Look, just did I turn it off? I didn't even turn it off. Shit. Bloody hell. Good job nobody's texting me. Right, okay then, guys. As always, thank you so much, Lauren, for helping me out here with this episode 50. Derek will be back next week with, hopefully, fingers crossed, the in-studio guest. Okay. Right, okay then, guys. Hope you enjoyed this Olympus Pro live stream review. Obviously, with the two winners from the two last pro shows, the Last Chance Saloon for the qualifiers for the 2023 Olympia. All the pro shows from now on will be qualifiers for next year. Should I talk about Prague next week?
Yeah, go for it.
I'll talk about it next week.
Okay, never mind.
Anyway, I think I mentioned it last week anyway.
Giles will be live streaming in Prague.
Yeah, and don't say who with because it's not confirmed yet. But I will have a rotation of some very cool co-hosts.
And just to let everyone know, I am not out of live streaming. I'm just taking a break.
Taking a break. Okay. Well, hopefully you can get your ass and come with us.
Yes.
I think because you had such a good time last year, Lauren.
But what was I going to say? Yes, Giles will be live streaming in Prague.
Yeah. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Okay. All right. God, nag, nag, nag. Right, okay then guys, hope you enjoyed this episode. As always, please do not forget to like, share, subscribe and hit the notification bell. And that is it. So as always, thank you so much for watching, thank you for supporting, and ladies and gentlemen, we are out.